Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2021 graduation acknowledgement for our Grade 8 graduates. We are so pleased that you're able to join us this evening to recognize the superior graduates that we have before us. We are so proud as a school to be able to recognize them for their incredible efforts and achievements that they have demonstrated throughout their years here at St. Therese of the Child Jesus School. My name is Elizabeth Wilde, and I'm currently the Vice Principal of St. Therese, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to our virtual graduation ceremony. Now, recognizing that under typical times, we would be able to gather as one community in one place under one roof to acknowledge our graduates. Unfortunately, like so many things, due to COVID-19, we are unable to gather today physically as a community. But thanks to the magic of technology, we are able to gather today virtually to recognize our wonderful students. I would like to just begin with a prayer that is directed specifically to our graduates. Please join me in the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, surround those who are graduating with your grace. Bless them with hope so that they move into the future with eager and open hearts. Help them to put the knowledge, skills, insights gained through their education here at St. Therese of the Child Jesus School use for the good of all humankind. Inspire them to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. As they commence with their lives, may they grow ever more grateful and wise. All of this we ask in the name of Jesus, your beloved Son. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And reflecting upon this prayer, we really do turn our focus to the impact that we know that our students will have upon our community as they grow up and venture off into high school. High school brings so many exciting opportunities for our students, and we absolutely know that they are going to be facing, as the prayer suggests, challenges, but that they will overcome those challenges and learn a lot about themselves. And each and every student that has attended our school in our grade 8 class has so much to offer to the world, and we can't wait to see those things happen. So with no further ado, we will begin our graduation acknowledgement for our students. I hope that you enjoy your time with us today. And again, thank you so much for joining us, and we hope you enjoy. Take care.
We begin by acknowledging the land and our responsibility to care for and respect all that creation gives to provide us with life. The land upon which we live, work, and sustain ourselves is the ancestral and treaty lands of the Mishizagek Anishinaabek, also known today as the Mississauga of the Credit, the rightful caretakers and title holders of this land.
We also recognize that this land is rich in pre-contact history and relationships, which includes the Anishinaabek and the Onkehungwe, and since European contact has and continues to become home for Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples.
As a responsible community, we believe all people are sacred and possess inherent and immeasurable worth and dignity. Colonialism displaced and possessed Indigenous peoples of their ancestral lands and continues to deny their basic human rights, dignities, and freedoms.
We are committed to the sacrament of reconciliation, making reparations and fulfilling our treaty obligations, duties, and responsibilities as outlined in the Gado Naginina, Dish with One Spoon, Wampum. This treaty governs and affirms that we actively maintain mutually beneficial relationships and collectively respect and care for the land, water, and animals and each other in order to guarantee a good life for our future descendants.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. God our Father, you are the source of all life and the source of all love. You have created and formed each person here with a loving hand of care and a caring heart of friendship. Through you, our life is blessed with many good gifts. Make us truly grateful for all you have given us. As we come to the end of our time together at St. Therese of Child Jesus School, let us be thankful for all we have achieved through you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Loving God, today we come together to celebrate the end of a chapter for graduating students. Thank you for your presence in their lives. Thank you for allowing all of them to share their gifts with the rest of the world. Continue to help our graduates to grow in love and wisdom. Be near them and guide them in all their adventures. May they continue to be blessed in all they do, today and always. Amen.
Hi, I'm Trustee Bria Corbett for the Dufferin-Peel Catholic District School Board. It's been a year that has challenged you in profound ways. When the future is uncertain, God has promised us. Inspired by this year's Catholic Education Week, Nurturing Hope, I wanted to share my hopes for our 2021 graduates. I hope that you don't just follow your dreams. I hope that you make mistakes, but I also hope that you learn from them. I hope that you don't accept mistakes as failure. You are created in the image and likeness of Him. I hope you embrace your uniqueness and stay true to who you are. We are called to help one another. Friendships are important. I also hope that you befriend a person who doesn't look, think, or sound like you. I hope that you keep showing up for yourself. I hope that you never give up. I hope that you keep trying, and I hope that you understand the impact that you've made. And when you leave your school, because you are changing the world through Catholic education, hope, like faith, as small as a mustard seed, is not insignificant, and neither are you. I hope you realize that the heroes of this pandemic also include you. I hope that you do.
Hello, everyone. As principal of St. Therese the Child Jesus School, it is my pleasure to welcome you all to our 2021 Grade 8 online graduation, and to offer on behalf of the entire St. Therese the Child Jesus School community heartfelt congratulations to all of our graduates. You, the class of 2021, have endured some unique circumstances. You finished your last year of elementary school either in person or remotely, or hybrid, or fully remotely, or at one point in the school year, remotely, and since April, totally online, amid a pandemic with continued calls for racial justice. Your final days as a grade 8 student may appear to be coming to an end without the athletic tournaments or academic competitions, award ceremonies, and milestones with friends. We have been made to feel very uncomfortable. It makes me wonder, you wonder, when things like this happen, when a pandemic exposes the real viruses of society, what are the gifts? What are the silver linings? What are the lessons? Well, there's you. You still need to be celebrated and recognized for your accomplishments, even if it's not quite as you had imagined. Your accomplishments are our accomplishments. All great accomplishments are not achieved alone, and the milestone of graduating from elementary school is no different. even when all the attention seems to be focused on, you know, the pandemic. In fact, I would argue that this is even more important. It is even more important that we come together to recognize you, to acknowledge your accomplishments this year. No group of students has been exactly like you, and none after you will be exactly like you. You made it. The theme of Catholic Education Week this year was Igniting Hope, which is also a fitting theme as we acknowledge graduation today. As my good friend in my head, Oprah Winfrey, once said, delivering an online graduation speech of her own, "I know you may not feel like it, but you are indeed chosen. The class of 2021 for such a time as this." And it's true. If Oprah says it's true, it generally is true, in my opinion. But in choosing a Catholic education, your parents have modeled our faith the best way that they know how, while unselfishly devoting time and money to see that you are well provided for. Your parents have made sacrifices that you know about and sacrifices that you don't know about. They love you, they are proud of you, and they want the best for you. I have never met a more dedicated group of advocates for you, for your education, and for your future. Your grade A teachers, Mr. Quintana, Mrs. Cetra, Madame Davis, Madame Martins, and Mrs. Menezes, and Mrs. Mills and Mrs. Sherry, as well as your planning time teachers like Madame O'Neill, Mrs. Martin, Mr. Leo, and support staff, as well as office staff, Mrs. Lusk, Ms. Fazari, Mrs. Wild, and myself, have challenged you academically, spiritually, and emotionally, supporting your development in your final year of elementary school. Together, your teachers, along with Father Joyson and the parish team at St. John of the Cross Parish, have worked together with your parents to ensure that you know the importance of a faithfully formed, well-rounded education. I know that you are an appreciation to all those here today, remotely, that have journeyed along with you. Today, more than ever, complexity, diversity, and change are the new normal. It cannot be assumed that for a minute that what was done or was relied upon yesterday will be viable tomorrow. Don't be satisfied with answers that are correct. Instead, train yourself to look always for better ways, better answers. Go beyond Siri. Don't settle for just being a good and competent student. Be creative, be innovative, see the big picture, spread our faith. You are learning who you are and what needs to be done to build a better tomorrow. It is you, the next generation, that will make the biggest difference in the future. Now more than ever, your voice matters. Representation matters. Diversity matters. The completion of your elementary education is but another step in the educational path you are each embarking on. It will be new, it will be different, it may even be scary. Use your faith as a guide. Depend on your parents' love and support and seek ways to connect your new experiences to the many lessons that your teachers have taught you. Even though the appropriate pomp and circumstance that we would typically experience is changing how we recognize all of our graduates, the sentiment is no different. We are all so proud of you, and there has never been a graduating class called to step into the future with more purpose, vision, passion, energy, and hope. There is no way any of us could have predicted the events that would have impacted us today, especially when we were thinking about this last year at this time. There is still much uncertainty and many questions. In truth, there always have been. But what I do know is that your determination, perseverance, and your hope are the very things that are going to sustain you through whatever is coming. Your graduation from elementary school is no less important, your accomplishments no less significant, and your friendships no less essential. It is vital that you learn, that we all learn, to be at peace with the discomfort of stepping into the unknown. So with that, grade eights, I wish you the very best in all that you embark upon. It's a very sentimental year for me too, because of course this year I will be journeying along with you. We'll all be leaving together. And so I do wish you the very, very best. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of your accomplishments. And I wish you and your families who've supported you the biggest congratulations on this graduation class of 2021.
Lara Abualiasi, James Almeida, Sean Almeida, Maya Aruz, Andrew Botros, David Charles, Sergio Coba, Sydney Cocoluzzi, Troy Filio, Matthew Finnegan, Murillo Gradilone, Carolina Heiderbrasch, Olivia Nat, Dominika Miechkowska, Adrian Nagoy, Erica Pereira, Claire Pickney, Melanie Riscala, Karen Saber, Jacobo Sanchez Aristizabal, Amanda Sheba, Christy Sokoli, Samara Thomas, Julia Toledo, Ben Villa, Laura Ewan.
Amanda Augustine, Irene Andres, Alfonso Aponte, Jetsola Babalola Lucas, Miriam Buni, Yusuf Buni, Alexis Canning, Valerie Clavijo, Arthur Fusson, Adrian Furtado, Gabriella Gianetta, Natalie Gerges, Emma Gonzalez, Camilla Hincapi Alaguna, Jason Imafredon, Serena Mangiacasale, Fallon O'Donnell, Maximilian Opalka, Bruno Perez Avila, Rebecca Perez Davila, Alex Popa, Bishar Rameau, Sophia Recio, Cyrus Tahiri, Karina Robo.
Cassie Bim, Allegra Clayford, Victoria Cruz, Angela De La Riva, Danielle Da Silva, Caitlin D'Souza, Nathan D'Souza, Matthew Alicia Salazar, Emily Estrella, Andreas Gonzalez, Mary Gerges, Crisia Hermosa, Malcolm Igbenovia, Anna Lenado, Sarah Lee, Jaden Mehta, Aisa Mosanda, Cecilia Mosso, Christella Gonde, Avery Prasad, Reese Reed, Matthew Rigoli, Michaela Rwanda.
Alejandro Bustamante. Christina Correas. Jelena Cruz. Julian Cruz. Ava DiPaolo. Olivia DiPaolo. Sophia Dorego. Angelita Garate Jessup. Jones Guerra Rincon. Samantha Joy Jose. Kara Kelly. Kyle Marcus. Jalen Miller. Michael Newhook. Darius Spence. Cameron Tomko. Joshua Valkovic. Krisha Daniela Vala. Gabby Wojat.
Anthony Kiernos. Ave Rabanello. Jacob Sinobio.
Broken down and tired of living life on the merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains, we gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I do it 1,008 times again. And I'll rise up, I like the way.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me. Like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count.
Dum 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 dum. ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through.
Close to the ones here today,
close to the ones that we lost on the way, cause the dreams
bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back you.
There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feel like December,
December
when somebody say your name,
cause I can't reach out to call you.
Graduating classes of 2021. It is an honor to stand here today in front of all of you. The graduates have come so far in the last 10 years that we've spent in elementary school, even if the last couple years didn't go as planned. To see this, to see how the people here today were shaped and how they came to stand here today, we'll start at the beginning, the very beginning, of elementary school anyway. 3,950 days ago when we first walked into school. Whether it was at this school or another, we all had that dreaded first day. Holding on tight to your parents' hand, crying, screaming, while the kindergarten teacher tried to comfort you and introduce you to the other kids who were all in the same boat. We did everything we could to get away from the school, but it wasn't so bad. As a matter of fact, we all would have gone back to that kindergarten classroom and would have colored with markers all day, any day of the week, instead of trying to figure out algebra. Really, ever since we put down those markers on the last day of kindergarten, we've been counting down the months, weeks, and days until we could all stand here where we are today. But being here today means that we should close this chapter of our lives, leaving behind amazing teachers, friends, and memories that this school has provided us. But closing this chapter of our lives also lets us start a new one, the chapter of high school, and I'm gonna guess that it's gonna be a pretty long one. So before we close this chapter for good, leave it a memory, a part of a book that we can go back on and read, I'd like to thank some people who helped us get here today and look back on the last 10 years of our lives. First off, I'd like to thank our parents, who helped with last-minute homework projects and took us on late-night shopping trips to get poster board. Not only that, but they believed in us, we didn't believe in ourselves. They were there for us if we had a bad day, and they pushed us to become the best versions of ourselves. Beyond our parents, our aunts, uncles, grandmothers, and grandfathers were also there to encourage and inspire us every single day. I would like to thank our teachers, who without we'd be nowhere. Our teachers pushed us every day and never let us give up. They themselves never gave up on us, no matter what the world threw at them. This year we may have been physically apart, but we were never disconnected because of the amazing teachers and staff that St. Therese the Child Jesus has provided us. Our teachers have taught us so many life skills and lessons that have helped shape us all into the people that we see standing here today. Finally, I'd like to thank our friends, arguably the only thing that we looked forward to in going to school, the people with whom we ruled the school and walked the halls. Our friends are the people who we trusted and the people who watched us grow and become who we are today. These are the people we spent dances talking to and the people we give that look to when teachers announce projects with partners. These people have been with us for so long, and I watch them all discover and devote themselves to the things that they care about. And by walking through the school, you can see how much our graduating classes have impacted and changed the school by doing this. You can see their artwork on the walls or the banners they've won in the gym, all pieces of evidence that this graduating class discovered and devoted themselves to the things that they were passionate about. And because of that, look how far we've come from that first day of school 3,950 days ago. I hope that we've come far enough not to scream and cry on the first day of high school, on the outside at least. So now, the path that we've been walking on together splits off into our own little trails, which we will follow throughout our lives. Sometimes, parts of the trail may feel rocky, but things will smooth out. Never give up, and remember that you are capable of so much more than you think. After all, we managed to graduate throughout a global pandemic. So, I hope our trails will cross again, as it has been an honor graduating with you. As our favorite teacher, Ms. Frizzle, would say, it's time to take chances, make mistakes, and get messy.
Gracious God, bless our graduates as they go forward into the future. Remind them that the past is done and that all they have is the journey ahead of them. Illuminate their path with your everlasting light. Guide them so that each step they take is a step closer to your love. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Dear graduates, God blessed you with unique talents and abilities, and you have used those gifts well. You have taken nothing for granted. Rather, you have worked hard to prepare for a challenging future. Just as important as the lessons that you have learned in the classroom are the ways that you have grown as a person. The friendships you have formed and the deeper understanding you have acquired of yourself and others. As you celebrate this milestone in your life and look towards a new horizon, never forget what has brought you this far. Remember the love of your family and friends. Remember your own sacrifices and hard work. And remember that God has a special plan for your life. You have so much to be thankful for and so much to look forward to. May today mark the beginning of many new joys and accomplishments and a continuation of all the good things that you have already achieved. So let's raise our hearts in prayer for all the graduates as we say together, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. And we pray together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And graduates, please bow your heads for a blessing. Gracious and loving God, we ask you now for your almighty hand to be upon our graduates as they and their families celebrate this grand milestone. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and success. Enable them to stay true to their dreams for your greater glory, to discern what is right, good, and just, and to use their gifts wisely and in service to others. Lord Jesus, look down on these young people with your favor and shower them with your love. Let your presence by the Holy Spirit be felt in every step of their lives. In times of sorrow, comfort them. In times of uncertainty, guide them. In times of joy, surround them. Lord, we thank you for all the lives of these young people and for all the hopes and dreams they present. Send them out not only to make a difference in the world, but to be a difference. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All the best and all the blessings. Congratulations to all graduates.
We are now at the conclusion of your graduation ceremony, class of 2021, and we're all here to send you off with a few special words.
Congratulations, crew. Respect, excellence, and work for life.
All the best, my shining stars. I will miss you. Remember to try everything.
Bravo et félicitations, les huitièmes. Congrats, grade eight.
To my amazing eights, félicitations et bonne chance.
Congratulations, my superheroes. I wish you best with your future and God bless.
Congratulations, grade eight. I wish you all the best and we will miss you.
Congratulations on completing your elementary journey, grade eights, and what a journey it has been. Wishing you much luck and success in high school. Good luck, bonne chance.
Congratulations, grade eights. Some of you I have known for 4 years and others for 10 years. The time has gone so fast. I wish you luck, I am proud of you, and I will certainly miss you.
Wishing good luck to all of our grade eights. I know that you are venturing on to high school, which is such an exciting time for all of you. Wishing you the best and very much looking forward to hearing stories about your wonderful ventures as you grow up. God bless each and every one of you. Have a healthy and safe summer and enjoy next year.
For graduates, always remember our faith reminds us that we are people of hope. Hope that we will be protected and loved throughout our lives no matter where we go. And because we are united as Christ's family, I pray that our paths will cross again. On behalf of the staff, I'd like to once again congratulate the graduating class of 2021. We thank our community and special guests this evening for their continued support. Good night, God bless, and remember to be kind to one another.